Lafayette Avenue Presbyterian Church. In this place, we join each other across the world, different devices at different times, yet we continue to be drawn by the same truth. No matter who we are, no matter where we are on life's journey, we are welcome here. So in that spirit, let us begin our time together by reading the responsive opening words found in your bulletin. Stay with us, Lord, for it is soon evening, and the day is almost over. God reveals deep and mysterious things in word and song, and knows what is hidden in darkness. God is surrounded by light. To you, O God, we give thanks and praise. Will you join me in prayer? Merciful and compassionate God, we thank you for having gathered us together. We thank you especially for the incredible talents of these young artists, and we ask that you would bless them for sharing their gifts with us today. In hearing their music and their words, we ask that your spirit might speak to us, that we would find sustenance and renewal in this hour. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. And now, may I introduce the one and only, the unparalleled, the man behind LAPC's Jazz Vespers program, Craig Bannister.
Thank you, Morgan. I don't know if I deserve such an illustrious introduction, but I'll accept it. So, and I'm not the only person behind it. So many of us are behind it. You all are behind it because you're here with us this afternoon. So give yourselves a round of applause, please. Thank you. So when we started our Vesper services, we wanted to always have a moment, a dedicated service to highlight and feature up-and-coming jazz musicians. And this afternoon is no exception. You're about to hear from, be lifted by, and enjoy some exceptional musicians this afternoon. So just, I'm not gonna stay here long, because we wanna get to the music, but I just wanna please invite you to enjoy, to celebrate, to worship any way you want. You can snap, you can tap, you can stand up, you can wave, you can say amen, you can say everything you want to do. And I just want you to just enjoy yourself in this beautiful sanctuary. Take a moment away from your week. Just soak it all in, take in all the beauty. And I'm just so inspired and hopeful for the future that's over here. We had a wonderful service today that highlighted the future members of our church and congregation, so it's no coincidence that we're here together to enjoy some more future energy. So without any further ado, the Tyler Bullock II Trio featuring Ikep and Quelle.
Hi, first of all, I'd like to thank Craig and everyone at Lafayette Avenue Presbyterian Church so much for having us. It's such an honor to be here and share this music with you all. First, I'd like to introduce the band. Joining us on vocal, I have one of my favorite young vocalists that I've had the pleasure of working with in New York City. We met as students at Juilliard. I'm still there. She just finished her master's degree. She's originally from Washington, D.C. She's just incredible, and I know you guys are going to love her. This is Ikep and Quelle. On drums, we have one of my close friends. He's actually the son of another great drummer, Rudy Royston, and a great pianist named Shami Royston, who is the sister of the great saxophonist Tia Fuller, if you're familiar. Kobe and I met at a summer camp called NYO Jazz when we were just finishing high school, and we've spent a ton of time hanging out. Kobe's one of my favorite drummers to play with. Currently goes to school at Peabody in Baltimore and is just killing it, and I know you guys will love him too. Kobe Royston on drums. On bass, we have Jeremiah Edwards. Jeremiah is from Maryland, right, originally? Maryland, Detroit, he's moved all over the place. Jeremiah is also incredible. Jeremiah actually just got off being on tour with one of the greatest living saxophonists, Kenny Garrett, in Europe, and just absolutely killing it. And yeah, Jeremiah Edwards on bass. That first little piece that we played briefly, we'll play a longer version of it at the end, but well, that was an original of mine entitled Joy. Next, we're going to go into a tune made famous by Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers entitled Moanin', with a Caps version of it on vocals, and then a tune made famous by Abby Lincoln called Cage Bird. And then finally, we're going to do a tune called Naima's Love Song, written by John Hicks, with lyrics by Betty Carter.
Trouble I see, life's a losing Thank you.
cherishes to be your dad. She's wonderful. You can play too carelessly without a fear. What's the come? Tears your soul. The chance to take that you must love her life. To see, to give, to take.
next one is called Don't Ask the Poet. In the dark, I like to think of your breath as a comma splice, something to be groaned at, patching together two uncertain halves. Not everyone can look like the dirt, the smog on November's spit, the bark of a London plane, the jowls of an old dog, the bowels of a hospice grandma. If you asked the poet, you'd think I meant ugly. If forget-me-nots whisper beauty, the rim of gold licking up the day's end, then you are ugly 100 times over. But there's the way you make me feel strong. Eyelashes tiptoeing on cheekbone, scratches sweet under the ear. Your mouth, that chapped and ripped land bordered by chipped china teeth. You have things like a voice, the plastic, and a drifted candy wrapper, dust bunny hair, the dreams of a bottom feeder heading up. For you, I crave to be, again, a scrappy tin can, rusty and worth it. So, it's my last week of school this week, this upcoming week, and I'm in a poetry class at school, and for our last week, I wrote this poem about the year, the end of the year, so, yeah. Yeah, I like it. It's called At the Station. Holding the year in two hands, an impossible weight. Between your palms, a couple months' liminal space. You wait at the station for the train to creep back around, but who's to say the train will come again? We could stay here, hang our legs off of the platform's edge. We could sleep here. We could whistle out something pretty and watch it echo off the tracks like a skipped rock. I'd like to think it all over again. After all, spring was only half bloomed, the winter half snarled through gritted teeth, the autumn leaves still caught in my gutter. I'd like to tie me to the rails with rope, a silent film snuff. Just keep me off the train. I'll do anything. But we can't stop the end from snaking up to us, shrieking out steam before snatching us away to some foreign world. There are no instructions on how to hold a year with two shaking hands. I am still fumbling with my ticket's edges and my dying paperback, ridden with dog ears, the normal train station habits, when of course, myopia has read me the ticket's numbers wrong, so the train whispers in too early, a rueful grin. We keep our heads down as the doors open, but I catch the eye of a woman stepping onto the last car. She's struggling to hold this heavy year all by herself, which hasn't even taken its first breaths yet. So I walk over and we hold it up together. We step onto the train with rocks in our shoes. We watch the platform slip away and learn our bearings as the bricks unclench their teeth. Thanks.
Gracious and loving God, thank you. Thank you for being with us when we needed it. Thank you for listening and comforting us, for speaking your truth and teaching us, for forgiving our mistakes and sharing our successes. Thank you for giving us someone to trust and believe in. Thank you for giving us this time to serve, but also check in with one another. Thank you for our gifts and the times we get to use them. And thank you for always looking out for us. May we continue to be blessed with all that you do for us. We pray all these things in the name of the one who taught us to pray, when he said, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts. At this time, our ushers will now collect a free will offering which supports the many ministries of this church.
Thank you. Thank you. You didn't, but you probably should. No. You're a big fat liar.
Masterpiece entitled Solitude, and then we're going to go back into the piece we did at the beginning entitled Joy. Once again, thank you so much again to Craig Bannister and everybody at the Presbyterian Church for having us. Hope to be back sometime, and I hope you all have a great rest of your day.
In my solitude, you hold. gone by. In my solitude, you taunt me with memories that never die. Thank you.
But I have to say, I just have to say a few thank yous. So thank you to everyone who's here this afternoon to enjoy this moment, enjoy these moments. Thank you to our ushers. Thank you to our AV team. It's been a long day. We have one more song to close out with. I'm sure you can hang in there. I feel energized. I don't know about anyone else, but I'm really energized. Thank you to our sensational readers, liturgists, poets. Thank you, Philip Kellogg. Everyone knows Philip. Philip is the one who does all of the advertising and the marketing. I know he doesn't like to be pointed out. Those of you who don't know him, I'll tell you later when it's back his turn. But thank you, Philip and Debbie, for the support. Reverend. And once more, Tyler Bullock II. Jeremiah Edwards on bass. Colby Winston on drums. Ike and Kai. So, I have a little inside information. Ikep is one of our own. Carla Cook, that's her student. So Carla, I have a question. So Carla, if I study with you, will I sound like that?
Yes.
I study with her, all right. Well, without further ado, the Tyler Block, the second trio, close us out, thank you.